Yeah, Lordo's Sunday Deep Dive brought to you from Jazz and Alan, the team there at Unique Wrought Iron, where thousands of Aussies go each and every day, each and every week, all through the year to improve their homes. And, of course, the doors are back open now. We're out of lockdown, and not that they ever stopped doing business. They did it all online, but now you can actually go and have a look in person.
TJ, it's all about record-breaking today because Travis Boak breaks the all-time Port Adelaide record held by Kane Corns, currently equal on 300
Lord,
games.
Why do that to Kane?
Because he's got to deal with it. I had to deal with it when Buddy took over my goal-kicking, and it's hard. He's got to accept it, Kane, so he becomes the game
record. Well, how does Kane feel about it?
Kane, how are you feeling about it?
No, I'm okay. To your point, Lordo, he's always been on the cards for a while. He's got a lot of footy left in him, and he's been a champion of the footy club, so hopefully they get up for him today.
Yeah, okay, don't overdo it.
So, what we're going to look at is great record moments in football, but also Brownie's got one from another sport. So, I want to go back to 1995, and this was Tony Lockett. Would you believe he kicked his 100th and then he kicked his 1,000th in the same game? So, here's his 100th goal. So, he's playing the Dockers, and the Dockers are going to wear this jumper today in retro round. So, he kicks his 100th, the crowd run out, and on the same day, he kicks his 1,000th goal, and they run back out again. So, what a freakish player he was. So, that's 100. This is 1,000. So, poor Stephen O'Reilly, Bill, was under the pump there.
Remember when they recreated it for the ad, Toyota, was it? You know, the two guys that Stephen... Yeah.
Yes, yes. I haven't seen that.
Auto segment.
Yeah. Anyway, so that is that. The goal umpire gets tripped over by fans running out. So, he was an absolute freak, and then years later, 4 years later, he broke the all-time record for goals. Here's Tony Lockett playing on Mel Michael. I'll never forget the day watching this and wanting to see him break the record.
Kick, was it? The
wobbly. Round 10, 1999, he kicks his 13th, 100th goal to go past the all-time record by Gordon.
This whole segment about Tony Lockett.
No, good. That was Gordon Coventry, the record he broke. Over to you, Damo.
Isn't TJ next up?
TJ, sorry.
Okay, well, we're going to go to round 17 of 1994, I believe. And this was one of the more emotive moments for the West. It was the day that Dougie Hawkins broke the great E.J. Witten's record. Now, E.J. had chalked up 321 games. And Dougie, who, of course, an icon of his time at the Witten Oval, Western Oval, and still is an icon in the West. There it is there, when he embraced Teddy, and even though Teddy might have been battling a little bit at that particular time. Look at the energy that he mustered and then gave him the flick pass there, and it became Dougie's day again. So well done to Dougie Hawkins. A beautiful moment there with the late EJ.
He'd be watching too, Doug, sitting up there at Bacchus Marsh having a cup of tea.
Games record was Michael Tuck's with 426 until Brent Harvey reached that point and then went past it in round 19 of that particular season. Boomer ended up tallying 432 games, which is the new AFL record for games played. But he went out strongly. His numbers in his last season and his last games were as good as at any stage of his career. And he wanted to go around again, Lordo, but ended up having to call it quits at the end of that particular year. Game 4-3-2 being the final one for the great Boomer Harvey.
Probably could have kept going too, the way Boomer was travelling. Yeah. He still looks as fit as anything. 1998, Jim Steins broke a record. That was 244 consecutive games he played, which was a record. This was round 17, 1987 in round 4. What a player he was. So tough. The way he transformed the way the ruck was played, Bill.
Yeah.
What an athlete he was.
Wasn't he?
Obviously so durable, what he played with.
I was at the MCG Boxing Day 2006. Shane Warne, our greatest ever leg spinner. 700 wickets. Have a look at that. Just the outside Trescott thing. It came back and...
Wasn't Trescott.
Strauss. But he got a lot of wickets against England, TJ, and I loved this day. I loved it. I was there. It was a great day.
But you couldn't remember the batsman.
He got so many of them, TJ.
700 of them.
700 of them.
Warney will be watching.
Warney
will be watching.
Beautifully flighted. But you would have gone back and gone bang, wouldn't you?
No, just come forward.
What about 1992 here? A world record score. World record score up at Metricon. Nowadays, what was it called back in the day?
Carrara,
exactly. The Cats kicked 37 goals, 17, 239.
And Bill?
Wait for it, because it was all locked up with Fitzroy. They'd kicked 238 points before. And this is on the siren to get the world record score. Well done, Anthony William Brownlow.
Did you have a few frothies?
I did. 37-17, 239. 7 goals in the first quarter, 9 in the second, 7 in the third, 14 in the last.
And you only kicked, I think, 2.
Damien, I played at centre-half back.
Out of 37.
I played at centre-half back.
37.
I kicked
two, and I played at centre back, Damien.
You had three kicks.
When did you play at centre back?
Good contribution, Bill, to that record.
Damo's kicked 10 before in a game, so he knows where the goals are. Don't worry about that. Let's go back to 1990, and the record for the brothers that have played in any one game is 4, of course, for Essendon. Oh. Anthony, Terry, Neil and Chris running through the banner there. So there's never been 4 brothers play. That was a record, round 22, 1990 versus St Kilda at Moorabbin. And what a legacy that family continues to leave.
When it's your segment, you can do what you want. So this was the day Lordo broke the all-time Essendon record. So Madden had the record.
It
was the Bulldogs. It was 575 goals. This is Lordo's 576. And what's the crowd? You see, what's the crowd, Bill?
Tell me
who's there. There's Damien Cupido saying well done.
Look at Lordo looking at the scoreboard.
There's Simon realising the record's been broken. And then Fletch broke the next record of his game.
Who's there?
You'll see, it's coming. Well, it's coming.
Are we seeing the whole game?
No, there's Kyle's. There's Kyle's mum, Lisa, and my mother-in-law, Mary.
So, how good.
That was great day, TJ.
I'm just looking at Kylie's face. She's thinking, God, I wish I was somewhere else other than sitting here watching. Do a little bit Matthew.
Something else, TJ, Matthew. How happy does Mick Malthouse look in this next piece of vision you're about to throw to?
Well, look, Mick didn't wear a smile on a 24/7 basis, but he would have to have on this occasion because this was the night that he broke Jock McHale's record as he walks out with some of his grandchildren there. And look, history means a lot to Mick. We know that. Whether he was in a Footscray top, a West Coast Collingwood, or a Carlton top. That was genuine. What we know now. But so there was Mick getting the record there, beating Jock McHale's record of 714 games.
Well done, Mick.
And it was genuine, of course, from Nathan there.
Well done, Mick.
Any more records left to go? Will Buddy kick the 1,000 for the last time?
Not this year.
I wouldn't rule him out, Bill. I would not rule him out. A little bonus by not being...
Give me a ruler.
I reckon he's got some theatre about him.
And I reckon, TJ, the way players are playing longer into their careers and into their 30s, I think the games record may get done.
The games record?
I think the way players are playing, I'm not sure what Kano thinks on this, but they're playing well into their 30s, more than I've ever seen before.
Burgoyne's not going to get there, wouldn't
it? I know Mundy's just signed for another year, but we're just going to see if someone can break it.
Oh, it's a lot of games.
What did you say?
Go, break.
He's... Hot music?
Yes.
No. Well, you just woke up, did you?
You're talking and he goes, go to a break. Yeah. Go to a break.